Good morning, children. Now let us begin our chapter 8, that is introduction to trigonometry. Now let us see the meaning of trigonometry. Trigonometry is a combination of three words, that is tri, that means three, and gon means side, and metric means measure. So with the combination of these three words, trigonometry came. Trigonometry means what? Three-sided measure figure. So three-sided measure of any figure means what? It is triangle only. But in this particular lesson, we will be dealing only with the right angle triangle. Okay, right angle triangle means all of you know, this is our right angle triangle where we have 90 degree. One of the angles will be 90 degree. So it will be A, B and C. Let A, B, C be the right angle triangle. Okay, let A, B, C be the right angle triangle with angle B as 90 degree. We know that if in chapter 7 of class 9th, where we have shown the triangles similarity ones and all proof we have seen, in that what was that? The largest angle opposite side will be always greater, is it not? So here you can see this angle 90 degree is the largest or the greatest angle among the three angles. Triangle means three angles, three sides, right? So we can write here triangle ABC is a right angle triangle. Right angle triangle. Okay, in which angle B is what? 90 degree. Okay, we know angle sum property of a triangle, that is angle sum property of a triangle equals to what? 180 degree. That means here you can see angle A plus angle B plus, this we have learned in class 9th. Remember children? Recall that, okay? So angle A plus angle B plus angle C equals to 180 degree. Now angle B is what? 90 degree. That means angle A plus 90 degree plus angle C equals to what? 180 degree. So that means what? Angle A plus angle C equals to 180 minus 90, which gives what? 90 degree. That means angle A plus angle C equals to 90 degree. Sum of these two angles is equals to 90 degree. Means each angle will be definitely less than 90 degree. That means angle A is less than 90 degree and angle C is also less than 90 degree. If any angle is less than 90 degree, then what are they? They are called, therefore, angle A and angle C are acute angle. Remember children, if any angle is less than 90 degree, then they are acute angle. So here angle A and angle C are acute angle because the measure of these two angles are less than 90 degree. Okay, clear? Now if any acute angle we are taking, okay, suppose I am dealing with this angle, this is called angle A. Okay, so angle A opposite side, which side it is? BC. So BC will be what? You can write side opposite to angle A, right? BC will be the side opposite to angle A. So this angle, this side will be what? Perpendicular. So this will be perpendicular, okay, or P. So this will be equals to what? P, perpendicular. Okay, same way, then if this is there, then angle A is lying on the side AB. That means this will be side adjacent to angle A, right? Because angle A is lying on this line. You can see this angle A is one of the part is this AB, means it is lying on this side. So this side is called what? Side adjacent to angle A, which is equals to what? B. This is called base B. Okay, and side AC will be what? And AC equals to hypotenuse. Okay, this is called hypotenuse because we know that angle B is greater 90 degree, so that is greater angle. So opposite side AC will be what? Opposite side AC will be what? Hypotenuse, or larger, is larger, therefore it is, that is why it is hypotenuse. Clear? Understood this one? So suppose like this it is given. So in this, now we know that AC equals to hypotenuse. Why? Because we know that in that lesson 7 exercise 7th one, 7.4, we have seen that in class 9 exercise 7.4 theorems and all, we have seen that angle, which angle is greater, side opposite to that angle will be greater only, remember children? So in that, now here you can see in this figure angle B, that is 90 degree, so side opposite to angle 90 will be the greater one. So here AC will be the greater one in a right angle triangle, will be what? Hypotenuse. The greater side is called what? Hypotenuse. So here it will be hypotenuse. So as angle B is equals to 90, so that means greater angle. So side opposite to angle B will be greater. So that is hypotenuse. Clear? Now here, suppose this side AC is what? Hypotenuse. Okay, that is H. Now, suppose these two sides are given. That means perpendicular is given to us and base is given to us. So, can we find H by using Pythagoras theorem? That we know that H square equals to P square plus B square by Pythagoras theorem. By Pythagoras theorem we can find that if P is given, B is given, then we can find H. And if P is not given and H is given and B is given, then also we can find using Pythagoras theorem. Clear? And suppose B is not given and H and P is given, then also we can find. Clear? Using this Pythagoras theorem, if two sides are given, then we can find the third side. Right? Remember children? So now, for each angle of this one, we will find angle A for sine. So now trigonometric ratios we will see. Okay? Related to angle A. So suppose I am writing sine A. Sine of angle A. This is sine of angle A. This can be written as sine A, okay, which is equals to what? Now sine A means this angle's opposite side is which one? Perpendicular, this BC. So it will be BC upon the hypotenuse, that is AC, which can be written as what? PB. BC is equals to what? P. So I can write this as P upon H. AC is H. In the figure you can see AC is H, so I can write P upon H. So here, suppose from the Pythagoras theorem, we got the value of P and H. Then we can find sine A. Clear? Same way cosine A. Cosine angle A, that is equals to cos A. This can be written as cos A. So that will be what? Cos A will be base. This one, that is AB upon AC. So AB means what? Base. So it will be B upon H. Okay. Same way tangent. tangent of angle A. This tangent of A we can write as tan A. Okay, so tan A means what? Perpendicular, that is BC upon AB, which is equals to what? BC is what? Perpendicular upon AB is base. Okay, so this you have to remember these ratios. Then only we can find sin A, sin B, sin C, all the trigonometric ratios. Clear? This formula must be known to you, these ratios. Now after that, cotangent. So cotangent of angle A, that is also known as cot A. Cotangent means cot A in short form. So cot A will be the reciprocal of tan A. So that will be reciprocal means 1 upon tan A. So 1 upon tan A is what? We have seen BC upon AB. So it will be what? AB upon BC. So which will be equals to what? AB is B upon P. Clear? Same way now, cosecant. This is called cosecant angle A. So which is equals to what? Which is equals to, we can write in short form cosec A, which will be the reciprocal of sin A. Reciprocal of sin A. So we know the formula, ratio of sin A, that is BC upon AC. It can be brought it as AC upon BC. Okay, reciprocal of it. So that will be just the numerator becomes the denominator and denominator becomes the numerator. So AC upon this. So it will be what? H upon P. Okay, same way now, second angle A, that will be written in short form like sec A. That will be the reciprocal of cos A. So that means 1 upon, that will be what? AB upon AC. So reciprocal means what? Numerator becomes the denominator and denominator becomes the numerator. So this will be AC upon AB. So that will be H upon B. So this type of ratio, suppose any P or B value is given, then we can find using Pythagoras theorem the H value. After getting P, B, H, we can find all these trigonometric ratios values. Clear, children? Understood? Now same way, suppose the figure changes. That means in the same figure, now in place of here, at the figure I am making, okay, so this is again a right angle triangle. Okay, here B is 90 degree. Okay, and this is A, this is C. Same figure again, I am redrawing it. Okay, so now if we are considering this angle C, you know that angle A and angle C both are acute angles. We have seen earlier one. And the angle sum property, through that we came to know that angle A and angle C both are acute angles. Now suppose in place of angle A, if I am dealing with angle C, okay, if I take angle C, then what? The opposite angle, opposite to angles, opposite side will be the perpendicular one. There see, angle A opposite, that is BC, was the perpendicular. Now here angle C I am considering. So angle C's opposite side is what? AB. Angle C's opposite side is what? Opposite side is equals to what? AB. That is equals to what? P. So here perpendicular will be AB. Understood? How the side changes? How the side changes? Understood, children? If I am taking angle C, then AB will be the perpendicular. Okay, just reverse of it. Then angle C is lying on the side BC, or you can say adjacent side to angle C will be what? BC. So that will be what? B, base. So this will be base. See the difference between these two figures. If I am taking angle C, then AB becomes the perpendicular and BC becomes the base. If I am taking angle A, BC became the perpendicular and AB became the base. Understood? Rest all method is same. So now this become base and AC is the hypotenuse because of the angle B, which is greater. Okay, clear? So now the angle C, now the trigonometric ratios will be what? Sine C will be what? Here AB upon AC, which is equals to AB is what? Perpendicular, means P upon H. Same way, now cosine we can write. Cosine C equals to cos C equals to what? Base, that is BC upon AC, which is BC is what? Base. So B upon H. Same way tangent C, rest all will be the same. Okay, so that can be written as tan C equals to what? That is AB upon BC, which is equals to P upon B. Same way cotangent C equals to, short form cot C, equals to what? BC upon AB, which is the reciprocal of tan A. You can write reciprocal of tan C, which is equals to 1 upon AB upon BC. So which will be BC upon AB equals to B upon P. Okay, so same way cosecant C, which is inverse of sine C, so which is equals to what? 1 upon AB upon AC, which is the reciprocal, means what? Numerator becomes the denominator and denominator becomes the numerator. So it will be H upon P. Same way secant will be what? Secant C equals to sec C equals to reciprocal of cos C, which is equals to what? 1 upon BC upon AC. So reciprocal means what? Numerator becomes the denominator and denominator becomes the numerator. So it will be what? H upon B. So now these ratios you got, trigonometric ratios. Now in this, suppose any two sides are given to you, that is P and B is given, then you can find H. And suppose H and P is given, you can find B. Suppose B and H is given, you can find P by Pythagoras theorem. After getting P, B, H, all these trigonometric ratios we can find using P by H, B by H, P upon B. Likewise, we can find all this. So let us deal with one question so that your concept will be clear about it. Okay? Now let us see one question, so that the concept will be clear to you. Question is, given tan A equals to 4 upon 3, find the other trigonometric ratios of triangle of angle A. So now solution, what you will write? Tan A equals to 4 upon 3 given. Tan A equals to, given that, given tan A equals to this, right? So tan A means what? We know that it is in the form of what? P upon B. What is the ratio of tan A? Tan A's ratio will be what? Tan A equals to P upon B, perpendicular upon base, we have seen previously. So that is equals to 4 upon 3. That means let the ratio be K. K be any positive integer. Okay. So what it will be? P equals to what? 4k and B equals to 3k. So using Pythagoras theorem, what you will find? H equals to square root of P square plus B square. We know that. So now use the values, that is 4k square plus 3k square, which gives what? Here 16k square plus 9k square implies what? 25k. K square, so it comes as 5k. That means H equals to what? Implies H equals to 5k. H value we got. Okay, so now sine A will be what? Now trigonometric ratios you can write. Trigonometric ratios are, first sine A equals to what? P upon H, we know that. Now here what is P? P is what given? 4K. So use here 4K upon what is H we got? That is 5K. Now KK got cancelled. What you got? 4 upon 5. So sin A will be in the form of 4 upon 5. Now same way cos A will be what? B upon H. Now put the value of B. B is what? 3K. So 3K upon 5K. So KK got cancelled. So it will be 3 upon 5. Same way now tan A. Tan A is already given. So no need to go for that. Now cot A will be what? Inverse of 1 upon tan A. What is given in tan A? 4 upon 3. So reciprocal of it, that will be 3 upon 4. Now after that, cosec A equals to what? 1 upon sin A, reciprocal of sin A. So that is equals to 1 upon, what is sin A we got? 4 upon, after that, cot A, cosec A, right? Okay, cosec A equals to reciprocal of sin A. So 1 upon, what is the sin A value we got just now? 4 upon 5. So write 4 upon 5, which will become 5 upon 4. Same way, sec A equals to what? Reciprocal of cos A, which will be equals to what? 1 upon, what is the cos A? That is 3 upon 5. So will be 5 upon 3. This way also, sec and cot and all you can find. And another way, what is that? Directly side also we know, that is cot A, this is OR, huh? This method I am writing this as OR. Or other method what? Cot A equals to what? B by H, B by P we know. B by P, ratio we have seen. Now what is B? B is 3K upon P is what? 4K. So what it is? 3 upon 4. This way also you can do. Or cosec A equals to what? H upon P. What is H? That is 5K upon P is how much? That is 4K. So which is equals to 5 upon 4. So you can see here also 5 upon 4. Then sec A equals to H upon B. That is equals to what is H? 5K and B is 3K. So KK got cancelled and we got 5 upon 3. So here also 5 upon 3. So either you can use the reciprocal of tan A, sin A and cos A, or you can use this way, ratios. Therefore, you can write, therefore the trigonometric ratios are 4 upon 5, sin A equals to this, cos A equals to this, tan A equals to this, cos A equals to this and sec A equals to this. Answer. Clear? Understood? So likewise, exercise questions we will see now. Now exercise 8.1, first question is, in triangle ABC, right angled at B, AB is 24 cm, BC is 7 cm, determine sin A, cos A. So now here sin A is there, means I am finding A angle 1, okay. So my trigonometric ratios will be different. When you will be solving, second question, second part you might have seen sin A, cos A, cos C is there. Sin C, cos C, that you have to solve as homework. And first one, that is sin A and cos A, I am going to solve it. Okay, so for angle A, BC is the opposite side of angle A. So opposite side will be perpendicular and adjacent side will be base. So AB is the adjacent side, so that is B. B is 24 and perpendicular is 7 cm. So by Pythagoras theorem you can find h equals to what? Hypotenuse equals to square root of b square plus p square, or you may write p square plus b square. Then put the values of each, that is 24 cm² and 7 square. Outside also you can write cm. Then square root of 24 square, you know that it is 576 plus 49. 7 square is 49. So when you add, you are getting what? Square root of 625. You know 625 is a perfect square of 25. So h will be 25 cm. After getting h, p, b is known to you, so you can find sin A. Sin A we know that it is p by h. So p by h means what? put the value of P, that is 7, and H is what? 25. So 7 upon 25, because both units are same, that is cm, so that will be cancelled off. So only 7 upon 25. Same way cos A. Cos A means what? B by H. So B is what? 24. So 24 upon 25. Units are same, that is why that will be cancelled off. So only 24 upon 25. What is this one? First one is clear. Second part, it is about angle C, which you are going to solve as homework. Angle C means this one's angle C's opposite side is what? AB. So AB will be perpendicular. P is given. Okay. And this will be base, will be adjacent side will be BC. That will be base. So base will be 7. So P and B will be given. Then you have to find H. Same Pythagoras theorem. Clear, children? Understood? So second part, do it as homework. Now come to the second question, that is find tan P minus cot R. Okay, so figure is given in the book also, PQR, where it is right angled at Q. So Q's opposite is what? Greater angles, side opposite to it will be greater. So greater means PR is greater, so that will be hypotenuse. Okay, so this is hypotenuse. Now angle P, if we are measuring, opposite to this will be QR. So this will be P and this will be B for angle P. So you can see that for angle P, opposite side to angle P will be QR. So QR will be P, and that we have to find because this measurement is not given to us. So we have to find that. Okay. And this will be what? B, and PQ is the adjacent side of angle P. That is PQ equals to B. B is how much given? 12 cm. So now H is given. H is given, B is given. So can you find by Pythagoras theorem P? That is square root of H square minus B square. Now put the values of each. H is 13 and B is 12. And outside write cm. Then squares you find, and then you will see that P equals to square root of 25 cm on simplification. So you know that 25 is a perfect square of 5. So out of the square root what will come? 5. So 5 cm. Now P is 5 and B is 12 cm and H is 13. Okay, all the three values we got. So can we find tan P? Tan P is what? P by Q, we know ratio. Now put the value of P and B. What is P? P just now we got 5 cm. So 5 upon B is what? 12 cm. So 12. Both cm, same unit, so that will be cancelled off. So only 5 upon 12. This is tan P. Now for Q, this R, cot R you have to find, this one. For this R angle, this will be opposite to this, means this will become P and this will become B. So that is what here it is written. When we take angle R, PQ is the side opposite to angle R. Is it not? So that will be P. P is equal to how much? 12 cm. And QR is the adjacent side of angle R. So that is equals to B equals to question mark. That is what you have to find. And hypotenuse is given as 13. So now again using Pythagoras theorem, we will find B. And that is square root of same H square minus P square. So now put the values 13 square minus 12 square. Outside cm. Now B equals to put the square of 13 and square of 12. And subtract on simplification, again you are getting square root of 25. We know that 25 is a perfect square. So B value will come as 5 cm. Okay. So now cot R will be how much? Cot R, we know that it is B by P. Is it not? Ratio we know. B upon P. So now what is B? B is 5. And P is how much? 12 we have seen. So 12. So 5 upon 12. Both P, tan P is 5 by 12, cot R is 5 by 12. So you have to find the value of that only. So according to question, what is given? According to question, you have to find the value of this. That is tan P minus cot R. Now put the value of tan P. What you got? 5 upon 12. So 5 upon 12 minus cot R is how much? 5 upon 12. So 5 upon 12 minus 5 upon 12 will be 0. So that will be the answer.